All right, hi, this is Aloy from LoyMacedo.com, and who's LoyMacedo.com? The date is 29th of May, 2014. The time is 3:15 in the morning. I happen to get this question. Loy, can you please tell me more about your high-fat protein diet? I have been researching about it for quite some time, but if you experience it, it's much better information. Can you tell me about it? Thanks. Okay, now, first and foremost, I just want you to know that I'm not a qualified doctor. I'm just going to share with you my personal experience of what has worked with me. Okay, so before you try any new diets or any new fats, make sure that you take professional or medical help. So first and foremost is you need to understand I come from an Indian background whereby we normally used to eat a lot of rice. We used to eat a lot of bread. We used to eat a lot of Arabic kubus. So this was our lifestyle, and we would eat more of this, and most of our foods were overcooked. Most of our foods were predominantly, it was like having too much of curry, too much of gravy, too much of flavor. That is how we would normally eat our food. And, it would be more of carbohydrates and less of meat. So meat was predominantly a luxury item. However, when I started moving towards my college years, I moved into bodybuilding. So I used to eat, once again, more rice, more carbohydrates, but I increased the level of amount of meat that I used to have. Eventually, this habit, moving into sports, I started drinking more of carbonated drinks, more of fizzy drinks, more of energy drinks, more of sweets, chocolates, ice creams, and with good as well as bad, I put on a lot of weight. From 55 kilos, I went up to 112 kilos. That was because I used to power lift. Now, I came to the part where I had to quit bodybuilding because my body couldn't handle the heavy weights. But my lifestyle of eating heavy continued. So all my muscles just started sagging and the fat accumulated. Now, I tried losing weight. That was for 2 years. I tried losing weight. I was pretty unsuccessful. I couldn't lose weight, so I was 100 kilos. Then eventually, I came down to reading about the paleo diet, the Atkins diet, and the high-fat, high-protein diet. Now, even intermittent fasting. I'll explain each one of these. So Atkins diet is predominantly eat as much as protein you like, eat as much as fat you like, but don't eat carbohydrates, don't eat sweets, don't eat anything that is fruits and sugary stuff. Okay, that is Atkins, hardcore Atkins. Then these paleo diet says you need to eat like how your ancestors, the early prehistoric man eat, because that is how you're supposed to eat. The industrial era gave rise to rice and pasta and processed food. You should avoid that. Then you have a high fat, high protein diet, which says eat anything with high amounts of meat, high amounts of protein, and high amounts of fat on it. That is good for you. And then you have intermittent fasting that says 8 hours, eat whatever you want, how much ever you want. But obviously, eat smart, eat more protein, a little bit of carbs. And for the rest, 16 hours, eat nothing. Keep your body empty, fasting. So now what I have been doing is a mix of paleo, Atkins, and intermittent fasting. So what do I do? And this is what I do. I first and foremost, I stopped having all sweet calories. Anything that was sugary, anything where I had to drink a calorie. So I stopped having all fizzy drinks. I stopped having all energy drinks. I stopped even drinking fresh fruit juices. Okay, because the logic is simple. If in a glass, a big glass of orange takes around, say, 12 oranges or 8 oranges. So instead of having all those calories in liquid form, I eat the orange. So within 4 oranges or 5 oranges, my stomach gets full. So it helps me achieve 2 objectives. One is I have the vitamins, the necessary ingredients of the orange. And at the same time, I filled my stomach and I had a nice amount of, let's say, fiber. So, first and foremost is I stopped having all fizzy drinks. I stopped drinking calories. The second thing what I stopped doing is I stopped having all bread, all rice, all carbohydrates, pasta, everything else. Yes, there are cheat days, which are once a week or once in 2 weeks, but I stopped this completely. Okay, you need to remove this off your system, and you need to understand that you will have the the cravings, because it's a habit. So it'll take you some time. It took me at least a month to get used to it. The next thing what I did was I had to cut down on all chocolates and ice creams because I used to love them. What happens is when you have sugar, it spikes up your insulin and then you feel hungry more, you feel like eating much more. So I had to cut down on all these. So this is the first thing that I did. Now, after I cut down this, obviously you need a substitute. So the substitute was I started eating more protein that is more egg, more meat, more fish, more whatever, anything that was meaty. And I started putting grass-fed butter, the milk taken from grass-fed cows. That butter I took, Kerrygold is a very good brand. So I use more of butter because butter kind of gives you energy. In fact, you can even try this. Have a coffee, take black coffee, and put a large chunk of butter inside it, and mix it really vigorously. You'll get a frothy drink that I used to drink first thing in the morning on an empty stomach. That used to give me the energy for the next 4, 5, 6 hours, but no sugar, nothing was there. So this I experimented. It's biohacking. You experiment with your body. So first I cut down all carbohydrates, I cut down all sugar, I cut down all sweets, and after that was done, I immediately switched to high protein, high fat. And then instead of having tea with milk and sugar, I started having green tea that was without any sugar. I started having black coffee but with butter. So that's what I started to do. Now, what was the immediate effect of a high protein, high fat diet? My body moved into being in a ketogenic state whereby my body temperature would go up. At the same time, I would feel like my body was burning fat constantly. I would always. Initially, yes, initially I did feel my energy fluctuate. I was feeling down. I had these headaches. But after a period of 2 weeks, I kind of got used to it. And today I feel much better. Today I don't have carbohydrates. I avoid potato. Yes, another thing. Yes, you need to avoid potatoes. You need to avoid overcooked vegetables. You need to avoid anything that destroys nutrients, processed food, junk food. All that has to stop. It has to be natural. It has to be fresh. So now, how does it help me? Is I feel the fat is constantly burning and it's burning much more faster. I'm eating, I think, much more than what I was eating before, but I'm burning also much more. I feel much more fit. I feel much more better. I've not checked my cholesterol, but my gut feeling says as I reduce more weight, I think I would be cutting down on my cholesterol as well. So right now, my weight before was 100 kilos, now it's 88. I would suggest what you need to do is Google and research paleo diet, research high fat, high protein diet, and research intermittent fasting. If you can research all these, you'll find out what is useful for you in terms of a high protein, high fat diet. And the nonsense that they tell you online, especially media companies, that you need to have high carbohydrates, you need to eat cornflakes, you need to have these energy drinks, you need to drink juice, and all that. It's total rubbish. The reason why they say it is because it's very profitable for them. In fact, I would recommend keep munching on hard cheese, which is really good. Keep munching on carrots and cucumbers, which is kind of good. Eat a lot of nuts. See, I keep eating a lot of nuts, walnuts, and peanuts. I just keep munching on them. So they're high in fat and high in protein. So this is what I recommend. Avoid anything that is processed. Avoid anything that is chocolate, donuts, ice creams. Just put one small little teaspoon in your mouth, so a tiny spoon, so you just get the flavor. That's about it. Avoid having too much of sugar in your body because too much of sugar and salt spikes up your desire and drive to eat more food. So it has worked for me. I think you need to experiment and find out if it works for you. And yes, if you're looking for ways to curb your appetite, because we tend to get very hungry, eat something spicy. If you eat something spicy or you drink soup, I think that kills your appetite. And yes, always make sure that you focus on keeping a good exercise schedule and going for walks, keeping your body always healthy. So this is Loy speaking to you about his high fat, high protein diet. Let me know what you think. If you have any ideas, feel free to share with them. And yes, please do research paleo diet. Please do research intermittent fasting. Please do research Atkins diet, because those have worked for me and I believe it'll work for you as well. Lloyd from LloydMacedo.com and whoisLloydMacedo.com addressing these questions. Thank you very much. Goodbye for now.